Hello, I welcome you to Erim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I will be taking you through Geography Form 3, Lesson Number 6. The topic it is External Land Forming Processes. I'm your tutor, Lucy Muthoni. Welcome. Let us look at the lesson goals. We are going to introduce the external land forming processes and then define the weathering and also look at the agents of the weathering. So we start by introducing the external land forming processes. Now these are the processes that operate on the earth's surface, and it mainly takes place through the denudation. Now what is denudation? It is the process of destruction, wastage, and removal of the earth's surface. So that is what we talk or what we will be dealing with when it comes to the external land forming processes. And for the external land forming processes, it carries a number of topics that we are supposed to cover. We have the weathering, we also have the mass wasting, we also have the action of ice, which we refer to it as the glaciation. We also have the action of running water, that is the rivers, the action of water and wind in arid areas. We also have the action of waves of the oceans and lakes. All that is external land forming processes. We start with the first one, which is the weathering. Weathering, we say it is the breaking or the disintegration and decay of solid rocks near or at the earth's surface without movement. So these rocks are not moving. They remain in situ, but they break, they disintegrate, and also they decay, and they don't move. The waste materials produced after weathering, we refer to them as the regolith. So they are referred to as the regolith. We go to the agents of weathering. When we talk about the agents of weathering, they are the ones that causes the weathering. One of them, it is heat. How does heat cause the weathering? Heat lends to the difference in temperatures that exert stress upon the rocks and influence chemical reactions within the rocks. So that temperature difference, it is the one that causes the stress. The temperature difference, it is the one that causes the stress. Thus resulting to the rock breaking down or disintegrating. That is how it will cause the weathering. Then the next one, it is water. When carbon 4 oxide that is present in the atmosphere is dissolved in water, they form a weak carbonic acid. So when these weak carbonic acids come in contact with the rocks, it will start reacting with the minerals present in the rock. Thus, disintegrating takes place. They dissolve those substances, they start reacting, breaking down, or even the rock becomes weak. Thus, disintegration takes place. Then the third one, it is plant and animals. Activities of the burrowing animals. We have the rodent, termite, encourages the weathering. And also when we talk about the plant roots, when they are penetrating through the cracks, joints, on the rocks, they result to the stress, thus facilitating the weathering. Now, what are the factors that influences the weathering? Already we are done with the agent. Well, we have said we have the plant and animals. We also have the water and also we have the heat. Now, what are the factors that influence weathering? One of them, it is the climate. Already we have said it is an agent of weathering. And also water. How these come from the climate. The main element of climate that influences weathering are temperature. We also have frost, rain, humidity, and the sunshine. How that now they go back to the heat and water. Chemical weathering is very pronounced in equatorial regions due to the hot and humid conditions. So you have now the chemical weathering taking place in the hot and humid conditions. Then physical weathering is pronounced in the deserts areas due to the extreme diurnal range temperature, very high temperatures and too low temperatures. And also when it comes to the precipitation, we have low precipitation with high evaporation rate in the desert areas, thus resulting to the physical weathering. Then the next one, it is the living organisms. Bacteria facilitate the decay of the organism, which produce the organic acid. The acid reacts with the certain minerals in the rock, resulting to the decay. Then we have the plant roots may cause rocks to crack when they are penetrating. And also, as they are penetrating, they are allowing the water seepage. And remember, the water starts reacting with the rocks. Then burying animals, we also have them resulting to the provides passage through which air and moisture can reach the rocks beneath the surface. Then we have the erosion. And Moses keep the surface of the rock moist. That's facilitating chemical reaction. Human activities, we have a number of them. Quarrying is one of the factors that facilitate the weather. Then we have the hoofed animals. They break the rocks as they are walking. Then the next one, it is the topography. On the steep slopes, the weathering materials are quickly removed by the agent of denudation. Thereby exposing the rock surface to the further weathering. Then gentle slopes arouse accumulation of the rocks materials in the one place covered with the rock beneath them. Activity define weathering. Number two, state the factors that influences the weathering. At number three, state the agent of weathering. For more information, you can visit the KRB 2003 Secondary Geography Student Book 3, that edition, or get us or through the SMS. You can also get us through the YouTube, also through the Facebook, and through the Twittering us. Otherwise, stay tuned to the RMTV. Thank you.